Welcome to Electro Online. Here our next problem in the JEE main test dealing with electricity and magnetism deals with an RCL circuit. So we have a capacitor, an inductor, and a resistor connected to an alternating voltage source. They tell us in the problem that the angle of frequency of the alternating current in the LCR circuit is 100 radians per second. The components connected are shown in the figure. Find the value of the inductance of the coil and the capacitance of the condenser. So they give us four possible combination answers. We have 0.8 Henry or 1.33 Henrys. We have 250 microfarads or 150 microfarads. So which of those combinations are correct? Well, the first thing we need to do is to realize that if there's a 15 volt drop here, a 10 volt drop here, and a 20 volt drop here, we can do a proportionality thing. For example, we can say that the ratio of the resistance versus the reactance for the capacitor can be shown as follows. So the X sub C divided by the resistance is equal to 10 volts divided by 15 volts. So we have 15 volt drop here, 10 volt drop here. So with that ratio, and we replace R by the 60 ohms, we can then see that 10 volts is 2/3 of 15 volts, so X sub C must be 2/3 of 60 or 40 ohms. We can do the same thing for the inductor, but in this case, the inductor has a voltage drop of 20 volts, so therefore the X sub L must be equal to 80 ohms because there's twice as much voltage drop across the inductor. Notice that they give us the angle of frequency in radians per second. So that means that omega is equal to 100 radians per second. And then we can find the equations for X sub C and X sub L. We know that X sub C is equal to 1 over omega times C, and X sub L is equal to omega times L. And from that, we should now be able to figure out the capacitance and the inductance. So capacitance is equal to 1 over omega times X sub C, which is equal to 1 over 100, and X sub C we said was 40. So that would be 1 over 4,000. So this is equal to 1 over 4,000, and that's, of course, equal to 250 microfarads. So we can see that it has to be either answer A or C. Now for the inductor, we can say that the inductance L is equal to X sub L over omega. In this case, that's 80 ohms divided by 100, which is equal to 0.8. And of course, that would be in terms of Henrys. So 0.8 Henrys, 250 microfarads. You can see that the only answer with both is equal to A. And so that's actually a relatively simple problem. Again, the first thing you have to realize is that you can find the reactance of the capacitor and the reactance of the inductor simply by using the ratio of the voltage drops relative to the ratio of the voltage drop across the resistor. If there's 15 volt drop across the resistor, then 10 volts equates to 40 and 20 volts equates to 80 ohms. We know omega is 100 radians per second. Of course, you have to remember the equations for the reactance of the capacitor and the inductor, and that's how it's done. You can probably do this one in less than 3 minutes and then move on to the next one.